I'll break the fight down with Munoz and Edgar. It was a great... You ever watch these guys in a park? They play speed chess with the timer. They got to go quick. Speed chess. It's great. Competitive. Always going fast, fast, fast.
It's a big game in the prison.
Well, this is...
You only had a certain amount of time. Let's go.
It works. This is speed chess with a little danger, baby. with a little, speaking about prison, you know what I mean?
Instead of hitting the timer, you get punched in the mouth.
You better be alert. You better be ready. You better be ready, you know, because at any moment, boom, something could come. So this is speed chess. And these guys, this is where I try to make sure they get the credit. At first, when the sport came around and they saw in your elbows and, you know, everything else, people, maybe myself a little bit included, again, full disclosure here, so people can't attack us from that end. Oh, yeah, Teddy, you want to tell the truth. You know, sometimes I would say it was barbaric. And it still has its elements. Boxing does too. But these guys are beyond just cavemen. These guys are tough, vicious, in a vicious, tough sport. But again, the separation is the smart, the guys that are a little smarter. These guys are smart. Munoz, he's a missile seeking missile, looking to come forward, does a lot of striking, but he's a missile with a computer chip. he don't just walk in and just let you hit him. He knows when to walk in, when to walk out. That's what I appreciate. That's what I saw. I saw Edgar, probably more versatile, a guy who could box, he did box. He recognized what he had in front of him. He recognized in Munoz that Munoz might have had the edge as far as power, striking, so he had to keep more balance. You know what it reminded me of in boxing, boxing terms? It reminded me of Pernell Whitaker with Julio Cesar Chavez Sr., two great fighters. Chavez trying to get in, Whitaker keeping more balance. It reminded me of that, really did, where Edgar was using his legs, using his wheels. He knew he had to try to keep the striker, Munoz, from being set. So he's boxing. He did it all night. And he's boxing. He's looking for spots to counter, to pot shot, keeping him off balance, moving around. And Munoz, he had to do something. And in boxing, you go to the body, take the air out of the tires with a guy that's moving a lot. In UFC, well, it's you kick and you knock the legs right off the axle. You don't just take air. You knock the freaking wheels off the axle, Ken. Right off the axle. And so what does he do? He starts doing these front kicks, you know, to egg his legs to slow down a little bit. And so he's doing that. And then he's also noticing that egg is a little faster, throwing more combinations, using his legs, you know, boxing. And he realizes that he's got to take speed out of the equation. He can't just walk in and get machine gun. So he controls range. He steps out a little bit. He's starting to control range, so he controls where the guy can use the speed and where he can't use it, where the speed is not an asset, where it's not overwhelming, where it's not dominant, where he leaves the guy shadow boxing by stepping out. Oh, you want to shadow box? Go ahead. I'll step out. I won't walk into it. Hey, that's pretty good. I like it. And timing negates speed. Timing can beat speed. So now he doesn't match the speed. Boom! Right hands. Nice straight shots. He starts timing Edgar. using timing to take away his speed. So I'm seeing all of this and everything else in the cage. Oh, it's tremendous. It's tremendous. And so I'm watching this back and forth. I'm watching the boxing keep on. I'm watching another guy trying to take the wheels away, knock the tires right off the axle.
Bust the tie rod.
And I'm watching the chins. Each one of them timed each other with right hands coming in. And they're, oh, great chins. You know, I'm watching all of this, admiring it. And it's a close fight. And back and forth with adjustments. And I probably have, I didn't write it down, but in my head, scoring and looking, I probably have Munhoz winning going into the fifth round. Probably have feel that he's ahead. And then definitely in my mind, the other guy's got to win the round. But anyway, and then Edgar, what does he do? He does what we want to talk about to everybody out there. You can't just be a bystander in your future. You have to be a participant. You have to take risk. And mm-hmm. with all that, you have to take risk. You can't just sit in the passenger side and say, yeah, it's a nice trip. It's a nice drive, you know. You could go a little faster. No, you have to take the wheel. You have to decide to go faster. You have to make those choices. And I saw it. And I look for it. And I appreciate it. And admire it. All of a sudden, both guys. But I see Edgar, who maybe had a little more desperation because I thought he was behind. All of a sudden, he starts taking more risk. Just still being smart, but instead of just moving and looking to pot shot, now he starts initiating, getting off first, initiating some of the attacks, not only taking what's given him, going out there and grabbing what's not given him. And I see him win the round because of that. I wish there were draws. I love the sport. I wish there were draws once in a while. I don't know if there ever are, but yeah. I never see them.
Very, very rare.
I, in cases like that, I wouldn't. I know that's part of the magnificence of the sport too, is that there's a winner, there's a loser. I get it, but once in a while, maybe, just maybe, could be a draw. That one was in that area, but it was in that area. But at the end of the day, like I just broke it down, I appreciated every ounce of that fight. It was like drinking on a hot summer day, drinking a 16-ounce beverage, and you enjoy every ounce, every sip, every drop. I enjoyed every drop of it.